I'm Brooklyn.
And I'm Venice.
And we're bringing you the news from the 007 studio. Visitor forms for prom are now available. Anyone who plans to bring a non-Scecina student as a guest needs to complete the form. See Ms. Hens in the office or Ms. Quigley to get one. Forms are due by Friday. It's Holy Week, Crusaders. There's no Mass on Wednesday, but we'll have a Good Friday service in the gym on Friday. It will be at the end of the day from 11:10 to 12:10, and we're on an early dismissal schedule that day. Please note that no lunch will be served and there will be no study hall. Seniors, the Scecina Women's Circle is hosting its annual essay contest for seniors only. Any senior may enter the contest. The winner will receive a $1,000 scholarship to a qualified post-secondary school. To enter, please write an original 500 to 750 word essay about a life lesson you learned at Scecina. Send your essay by email to bmurphy@scecina.org by April 3rd. Please write SWC essay in the subject line. Now to Venice for today's clubs and more news.
Thanks, Brooklyn. The Gaming Club will not meet today. Contact Mr. Block with any questions. The Creative Writing Club will meet today at 2:50 in room 209. The group will write about luck and lit and discuss a literary magazine. Contact Ms. Wetzel with any questions. Now back to Brooklyn for more news.
Thanks, Venice. If you're looking for a part-time job, Deering Cleaners is looking for help. Hours are from 3:30 to 5:30 on weekdays and from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. on Saturdays. You get paid weekly and pay starts at $10 an hour. Apply in person at 1160 North Arlington. Now for our verse of the day. This one is from Luke chapter 7, verse 7. It says, "Therefore I tell you, her many sins have been forgiven, as her great love has been shown. But whoever has been forgiven little, loves little." Jesus said this to Simon, a Pharisee. Jesus had been invited into Simon's home for a meal. A ceremonially unclean woman washed Jesus' feet with her tears and anointed him. And Simon was offended that Jesus allowed it to happen.
Yeah, and Jesus rebuked him by pointing out that Simon did not do the normal hospitalities when Jesus entered his home. But this supposed sinner paid him great honor by anointing him for a burial before his crucifixion.
This is yet another example of how Jesus respected women and stood up for them despite their low social status in his day. Now let's head outside to Bailey for today's forecast.
Thanks, Brooklyn. After a mostly chilly spring break, we'll hit 68 degrees today with mostly cloudy skies. It'll drop to 49 overnight, and some rain is expected in the early morning hours. Tomorrow will be similar with a high of 65 and more clouds. It'll cool down on Wednesday with a high of 50, but we should see more sunshine. Now back to the studio for more news.
Thanks, Bailey.
It's not so bad today. It's pretty warm.
Yeah.
Please remember that printed yearbooks are in the Spirit Shop for those who ordered one last spring. You need to pay the remaining balance of $33 when you pick it up. Contact Mr. Tooley with any questions.
March is Women's History Month, and we're continuing to recommend movies, documentaries, and other works that empower women and or shed light on women's history. Today we're going with 9 to 5, The Story of a Movement.
This documentary shares the story of a group of office workers in Boston in the 1970s, started a movement to improve working conditions for women. The group fought for better pay, more opportunities for women, and to end sexual harassment.
Dolly Parton produced a hit song called 9 to 5, and she also produced a movie with Jane Fonda with the same name. Although the movie was a comedy, it highlighted how different working conditions were for women. Here's a look at a short trailer for the documentary.
As secretary, you need to be the best you can be.
This group of women whose voice was not being heard.
There's something you can do about it. Everything exploded.
The movie was married to a movement.
They built their own kind of feminism, and it was powerful.
I'm not just a secretary, I'm a secretary.
The documentary is available on Netflix.
Now for our lunch menu. Today we'll have chicken nuggets with carrots. Tomorrow it'll be a hamburger or cheeseburger with corn. Please remember that all menu items are subject to change based on availability. Now let's see who's celebrating a birthday.
Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Yoo-hoo.
Oh yeah.
Enjoy your day, Crusaders. March Madness is underway, and we're down in the Sweet 16. Some students have been discussing which faculty and staff members would make the best starting five. The idea is to create the best hypothetical team, so we're ignoring old age factors like knee problems, back pain, or limited ability to get up and down the court. Here's a look at some Crusaders who choose for a staff basketball team.
All right, we're back, and who are you with today?
Zach.
Zach,
And what's your team look like?
So I got Ruff at the one. I got Tuli at the two. I got Klossy at the three. I got Blakey at the four, and then Dooley at the five.
Mm. All right, we're back, and who we're here with today?
Owen Weinzerl.
What's your team look like?
I got Potts at the center, and then we got Tuli, Ruff, Klossy, and Dooley.
All right, we're back, Red and Gold Show, and who we're here with?
Miss Myers.
Miss Myers, and what's your team looking like?
The entire social studies department and Mr. Blakey.
Mm. Okay. We're back, and who are we here today?
Keegan Ray.
DJ Mendez.
Bosco Rife.
Will Battles.
And what are your guys' team looking like, starting here?
I'm a star at the center position with Mr. Hubert. Pretty big man. He could probably throw down. I'm going to go power forward as Ben Potts. That might not be allowed, but I will put him there. Small forward, you're going to give me Joe Ruff.
Mm.
Joe Ruff at small forward. Uh-huh. Shooting guard, Mr. Tuli. And point guard, you're going to have to give me Mr. Klossy.
Mm. What about you?
So, same here with the center position, Mr. Hubert. And then point guard position, I'd probably switch it up, go Joe Ruff.
Ooh, okay,
then
okay.
The shooting guard position, Mr. Klossy.
Okay.
I accidentally said his first name over there, but you know. And then what else I got? Small forward, power forward. Power forward, Mr. Schroeder.
Mm,
and then small forward, that's a tough one. It's a tough one. Who are we going to go with? Mr. Stambro.
Mm, okay. I like that. Mm. What about you?
All right. At the one, give me the Dean.
Oh.
You know, he might have some sneaky athleticism to him. On the two guard, I'll go Tuli. You know, that boy can shoot. For the three, I'll go Quinn Klossy. Mm. Got that dog in him, you know. For the four, I'll go Mr. Hubert. You know, went to Notre Dame, got that fight in him. In the five, curveball, Mr. Spannin.
Mm. Okay. All right, we're back. Who we're here with?
Manny Roma.
All right, and what's your team looking like?
Starting five?
Yeah.
Give me Daniel Fox at the one. Klossy, he's a shooter. Put him at the two. Now we need a big, what's his name? Mr. Hubert, give him big. And we need another big, give me Mr. Potts. And one more. Who else? Who's another teacher? Mr. Ruff.
Okay. Cool. All right, we're back. And who are we here with?
Miss Jackson.
Miss Jackson. And what's your team looking like?
If I had to build a team of teachers, I would have my guards as Ruff and probably Fox. And then my forwards, I would have DeWilde and Klossy. And then my center, I would probably have Hubert.
All right, who are we here with today?
Jacob.
Landon Ross.
Oh, Wayne.
And what's your guys' team looking like?
I'm going to go big man, Mr. Tuli. Power forward, I'm going to get Mr. Fleming right there. And small forward, I'm going to need a shooter. And I know Klossy's a great shooter, so I'm going to get Klossy for sure. And then my one and two guards, I'm going to go Daniel Fox at my two guard and Mr. Ruff at my one guard.
I'm liking that. What about you?
I'll go Mr. Fox at the one. Then we can run with Ms. Jackson at the two, Ms. Wetzel at the three, and then Mr. Potts with the four, and then we can go with like a sneaky Mr. Hubert at the five.
What about you? What about yourself?
I get Mr. Ruff at the one, Klossy at the two, Tuli at the three, and then Mr. DeWilde at the four and Hubert at the five.
There you have it. Now we want to hear from everyone else. In our latest RG poll of the week, we want to know who you would choose at each position. The poll is up in Canvas, so give us your choices by Wednesday night, and we'll share the results in Friday's show. I don't know anything about positions in basketball, so we brought in some help.
Thanks, Brooklyn. You interviewed me,
And this team is probably a little bit more different because I went into more thought. So my five, Mr. DeWilde, big dude, definitely get some buckets. But at four, my dark horse, my underground specialist. I don't even know what I'm saying at this point, but he's a tall guy, Mr. Upchurch. He's gonna give you guys some buckets.
I didn't think about that one.
At my three, go sharpshooter, Mr. Tooley. At two, I'm gonna go with another sharpshooter, Mr. Clossy. He's a great sharpshooter.
Okay.
At my one, I'm gonna go Mr. Stambro at my guard. He's got that IQ, and he could command the offense real well. So.
Okay.
Yeah.
See, mine looks a little different.
Okay.
A little similar, just a little similar. Different. I got Hubert at the five, DeWilde at the four, Tooley at the three, Clossy at the two, and at the one, give me Daniel Fox.
Oh.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Okay.
He's a little sparky guy. He's a little spark.
I like his energy.
I like
his energy. And then at coaching staff, give me Miss Jackson and Miss Myers. And then.
Okay, I see how it is.
Off the bench.
I see how it is. Still my coach. Miss Jackson, I said you first, by the way.
Yeah. At the bench, give me Potts. Who else are we thinking?
Well, I was thinking Mr. Fleming. He's got good, big, broad shoulders. Probably dunk it.
Okay.
Back down, back scratchers, rim pulls, everything. I mean, I can see him do it all. But I also see Mr. Spandon coming off. I mean, got that big body. I guarantee he's got a nasty post hook, so.
I'm liking Mr. Spandon.
But Mr. Ruff, he is a tryhard at everything he does. So, yeah. I mean, no disrespect, Mr. Ruff, because I know you're watching.
But we did see him at the Peaks.
Yeah, we did see him. Yeah, so we know you would try very hard.
He has that speed. Give me
determination.
Yeah. Let's see.
Well, I think I've got my team picked.
Yeah, that's pretty much.
And give me Miss Rossworm. I already know she can shoot the three well, so I'll take
Miss Rossworm. She's putting it up there. So
I'll take Miss Rossworm, yeah.
That's what our team looks like. If I had a March Madness team, I'd feel pretty positive with my team. What about you?
Final four locks, but we're winning the natty. I don't care. Yeah.
So I'd like to hear. Yeah. Thank you for your guys' time.
There you go, Crusaders. Now make your own picks. That's it for today's Red and Gold Show.
Stay classy.
And give that little extra.